everyone. My name is Fola Jonfede and my brother Dola Bonfede. I hope you are having a great weekend. How are your online classes going? I hope you are going so well. It's time for the Word of God. Grab your book, pen, and Bible and enjoy the service.
Hello guys, how are you today? Welcome to Light Things online service. I hope you had a fantastic week. I'm super excited to be with you once again. How was your week? Type in the chat box how your week went. We want to hear from you, either on Facebook, on YouTube, or Instagram. Type how your week went. Okay, while you're doing that, I remember I gave you an assignment last week. I told you to tell me how you've been able to overcome a difficult challenge using your faith in God's word. So I want to hear that as well. Yes. So type also in the chat box how you were able to exercise your faith in that difficult situation that you were in. Probably you were in trouble with your parents and what you did and how God's word helped you to come out of that situation. Maybe there is something you are struggling with. Maybe there is a friend that you are struggling with and you use God's word to mend the relationship. Whatever it is, type in the chat box. We'd really love to hear from you. Okay, good. So today we'll be talking about a very interesting topic, and that's staying thankful and joyful. Staying thankful and joyful. For me, this is very interesting because we are in a very challenging time with the whole COVID-19 going on right now. It's really tough. It's tough on everyone, and there is need for us to know how to handle it. You know, apart from our faith, we also need to have an attitude of thankfulness and joyfulness. And that's why we'll be talking about it. Let me share this interesting statistics that I came across with you. And it's the fact that, do you know that an average child laughs 150 times a day? 150 times. Imagine that preschooler. That's your little sister or brother. He or she laughs an average of 150 times in one day. However, an adult laughs just 3 times in a day. So let me take a good guess. For a teenager, that would be around, let's say, 10 times in a day. What do you think? What do you think is the reason for that wide gap in the number of times an adult laughs and the number of times a child laughs? I want to hear from you too. So go ahead and type that in the chat box. Why? Why? Why don't teenagers laugh as much as children? I want to hear from you. For me, I think basically the reason is because you are responsible for more things now. I have a beautiful 2-year-old girl, and what all she does is to sleep, wake up, play, eat, and sleep. She just goes around that cycle. But as she's growing up and she becomes a teenager like you, you know, you are responsible for more things, right? Yes, I understand. You are thinking on how to pass your examinations. Even while at home, I know a lot of you are still being engaged online, right? So you are thinking of how to improve your scores in school. Yes. Some of you are battling with understanding your parents. Yeah, I understand that too, because I've gotten some comments, you know, from some of you. So that could be really tough. You feel that your parents just don't understand you. That's also a difficult situation. I clearly understand. Then probably some of you are going through some addictions. Yeah, some people might be going through peer pressure. Maybe there is this friend or maybe a group of friends that are doing some things and you don't want to do it because you think the thing is bad and you don't know how to cope through it. That's also a difficult situation. I agree with you. And some people might even just be going through some emotional, you know, roller coaster today. Mood swings, yes. Maybe today you are sad. Tomorrow you are happy. All these things are normal. And there's a way your father, your heavenly father, wants you to respond in this, you know, in that situation. So write in the chat, type in the chat box why you think we have that gap in the number of times we laugh. So basically, God wants you to laugh. He wants you to have fun, good fun. Yes, He wants you to laugh with your parents, laugh with your siblings, go out with your friends. Yes, but keep social distance, you know. go out with your friends. He wants you to be happy and joyful at all times. He wants you to put a smile on your face. Fenyire, right? He wants you to do all that. That's what God wants for you. He doesn't want you to feel sorry for yourself. Whenever you find yourself feeling sorry for yourself, know that that's the devil talking to my mind, because that's not God's will for you, right? So as we go on, I will tell you how to get yourself out of that mess. So let's look at Proverbs 17:22. It says, "A cheerful heart makes you healthy, but the broken spirit dries you up." Wow. I don't want to have a broken spirit. I hope you too don't want to have a broken spirit. Yes. So God wants us to be cheerful. He wants you to smile. He wants you to laugh. He wants you to be happy. That's God's plan for you. Anything contrary to that is not God's will for you. So you might be thinking, even in a scene, when I'm in trouble, am I supposed to laugh? Yes. In that difficult situation, God still wants you to maintain your joy. The reason is because He might not be able to do anything for you if you are not happy. Because He wants you to develop that attitude of being happy at all times in difficult situations. Okay, so I will narrate this story. There was an hospital where they had many, you know, patients that were not doing well. And what they did was they took them to a park for several hours, you know, just for them to watch children play and to hear the sound of children playing and laughing. Guess what happened? They discovered that their health improved. You know, the natural body healing process was stimulated and these patients got better. So it then means that laughter is good medicine, just like the Bible has told us. Let's also consider the story in John 6:1-12. That's the story of Jesus when he had a large crowd, 5,000 people following him. I had just fed them with the word of God, and he perceived that he needed to feed them. He needed to feed them. A typical Owambe would house about, on the average, let's say 500 people. But here, Jesus had 5,000 men. We have not even counted the number of women and children. But 5,000 men were in that gathering. It was a tough situation. When he asked Thomas, Philip, what he thought about it, what did Philip say? Philip said, even a man's half-year pay will not be able to feed all these people, even if they take just a bite. Can you imagine that? Just a bite. So that's to tell you that it was a difficult situation. And when he asked Andrew was being cynical or he was just being sarcastic. Andrew said, there's a boy there that has 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. Maybe he would be able to help or something. Apparently, 5 loaves won't go around 5,000 men. But what did Jesus do? Interesting. Jesus did what? Took the bread and gave thanks. Jesus gave thanks. And what happened? The bread multiplied. So you can see the reason why the Bible is saying that you should be thankful. It's because when you switch into that attitude of being thankful, maybe you just saw your maths results and you scored very low in that maths results. God still wants you to be thankful because He can change things for you. It's in that attitude of thankfulness that you will see clearly what you're supposed to do next time. But if you decide to be depressed, if you decide to go to one corner and not talk to your teachers, not talk to your friends, not talk to anybody about it, the devil will take advantage of you because that's what he does. The devil wants us to be sad. However, the Spirit of God wants us to be joyful. According to Galatians 5:22, I'm sure you know that song. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, and on and on. So one of the fruits that the Holy Spirit in you, remember the Holy Spirit is your friend. So this is how I like to see it. Holy Spirit is my friend. Jesus is my brother. God is my father, right? So you have a friend in the Holy Spirit. And what that friend is meant to do in you is to help you bear fruit. And one of the fruits that the Holy Spirit will help you bear is the fruit of joy. So if you are a child of God, you've given your life to Jesus Christ, and you have the companionship of the Holy Spirit as a friend, it will help you to be joyful. So maybe you have not been listening to the Holy Spirit. In that situation, probably you're fighting with addiction. In that situation, the Holy Spirit still want you to be joyful, joyful in it. That's one of the things that can help you overcome that tough situation. Remember Paul and Silas, what happened? Yes, they prayed, they sang before the door flung opened. So it was that attitude of joyfulness that birthed their miracle. So miracles happen when we are thankful. Miracles happen when we are joyful. Miracles happen when we give praise to God. You know why? Because God is so happy with us when we are when we praise Him, when we lift up His name, even though what we are facing right now might be difficult. Remember the Bible says that when you go through the fire, imagine the fire burning you. Say, though it burns, says the flame will not be kindled against you. So what does that mean? In that difficult situation, I will keep saying it. Be thankful to God. Also, the wall of Jericho, it fell down flat as a result of praises. So what are the benefits of being joyful? The first is that you are stronger. Like that heavyweight champion that is able to fight very, you know, hefty men. That's what happens to you when you are joyful. So our text for today, which I want you to memorize, is Nehemiah 8 verse 10. Nehemiah 8 verse 10. And it says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. When you are joyful, you are empowered to overcome. When you are joyful, you have strength in you to find solution to that problem. But if you are sad, guess what happens? That means you're a weakling. I'm sure you don't want to be a weakling. You want to be a strong girl for God. You want to be a strong lady for God, a strong man for God, right? That's what you want as a teenager for Christ. So you are stronger each time you are joyful in a difficult situation. And then I also want you to have this perspective that God is your father. So this perspective will help you to overcome any situation you find yourself. When you realize that God has my back, God is with me, God loves me, God will do anything to ensure that I am okay. Even though your earthly parents, your parents might love you so much, they love you so much, right? But there is someone that is perfect. Your parents are not perfect, but God is perfect. And He loves you more than your parents can love you. So when you have that mindset, you can be joyful in any situation. You can be joyful in any situation. And being thankful lifts your spirits. It makes you alive. People will want to be your friend. People don't like hanging around people that are always sad, always serious. You know, people love to be around people that are thankful, people that are joyful, right? So be that person that is always thankful. So how can you achieve this? I'll just give you two things. The first is to remind yourself of how God has helped you in the past. Remind yourself of that time when you prayed in class for God to help you through a particular subject. Or probably you prayed to God to give you admission. Or you prayed to God to, you know, you said a prayer in time past that God answered, right? I'm sure God has been faithful to you. Remind yourself of the victories in time past whenever you are faced with a difficult situation. And that will help you to be thankful because you know that the God that helped you then would help you now. Do you understand? Because God is always with you. So He will always help you through every situation. Remember Paul and Silas. They were in a tough situation, but God showed up for them. So God would also show up for you. Remind yourself of how He helped you in time past, and He will show up for you again. So the second point is to celebrate. Celebrate God. Thank Him for His faithfulness. Thank Him for being a loving Father to you. Celebrate with people. Celebrate your friends. Celebrate your loved ones. And finally, be thankful. Be thankful. Learn to say thank you to your parents. Say thank you to your dad, your mom, your friends, your siblings, and people around you. Remember, when we were younger, we learned the three magic words, right? So thank you is very magical. It helps to, you know, build your relationship and also helps you to maintain a thankful attitude. So in conclusion, there is something I want you to do. I want you to get a gratitude jar. This was something I did last year and last 2 years. I just got a transparent jar, you know, all those ones with different colors. And each time God does something for me, I pick a piece of paper, I write it on it, wrap it and throw into the jar. So I do that all through the year so that at the end of the year, I open it up and then I have plenty of testimonies to share, right? So I want to encourage you to also get a gratitude journal or a gratitude jar. This will help you to maintain the attitude of joyfulness and thankfulness. And remember that God likes it. God loves it when you praise Him. He loves it when you maintain a joyful attitude. So please, maintain your joy because that's what God wants from you. Remember our text in Nehemiah 8 verse 10 that says, in all things, the joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Thank you very much for listening. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for today. We appreciate you, sweet Holy Spirit, for your word that has come to us, for teaching us to be joyful and thankful people in all situations. And Lord, we pray that as we go through this week, that you bring your word to remembrance and you will help us to always thank you in every situation that we find ourselves, even in this COVID-19 pandemic crisis. Lord, we pray that it will not come near our dwelling in the name of Jesus, and you will help us to always be thankful to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you so much for listening once again. I hope to see you next week. Thank you and God bless you. I love you. Bye.
That was a great word from our teacher. I enjoyed the service. Did you?
Yes, I did.
See you next week. Peace.